All right, we got Mike Steffen, president of Cage Plow Systems and inventor, and we're going to be put to a test today. We're going to take it in a head-to-head comparison with a snow bucket and a snow plow, and we're going to see if this has what it takes to really move the snow. When you're done watching this video, you guys and gals out there are going to be able to determine if the cage system is right for your point out that Mike pointed out as the inventor is what he considers a floating system.
Right? Oscillation, yep. Oscillation. Allows the plow to oscillate and follow contours in the pavement without having to do minute adjustments to the loader arms.
He's got big words. See if his equipment can hold up to it.
All right, Mike, let's see that oscillation system you're talking about.
All right, so here is the cage unique oscillation feature here. These slots pivot, all this whole plate pivots right here, allowing the plow to follow contours in the pavement. And furthermore, even while it's fully angled, so this plow can be fully angled, and you can put down pressure on that loader, lifting the front wheels of the skiddy right off the ground, and that blade still stays perfectly flat, scraping constantly.
And I see what, tell me about this trip edge system. You have a four spring trip edge. This is a 9 foot cage.
This is a 9 foot cage system. The cage system utilizes compression springs and a trip mechanism. So the plow trips down here as opposed to tripping the entire mold board, so you don't lose your entire load of snow. This is critical when you're plowing with a skid steer. You need a trip edge so that you don't dump your load as you're going by, and you can scrape, put down pressure on that trip edge. The trip edge doesn't trip frequently, chattering across the pavement, so you lose your snow. The compression style springs are important to understand that they're not the hook style extension springs, so they don't wear out prematurely.
We're going to put this cage plow through two tests that you will typically encounter when you're in a commercial snow plowing situation. The first one is what I call curb cleanup and curb detail. And the second one is the hog event. Just can it move the mass quantity of snow? Now in this case, it's middle of February and it's pouring rain on us in Minnesota. Really unusual situation. So we had to actually stockpile snow around the curb line to make this event happen. Now this event was the cage against a bucket removing snow from a curb line. On our accounts, we have zero tolerance for snow above and beyond the curb line. So the way we typically have to do it with a bucket is back drag everything away so that we can then angle the machine to be able to pick the snow up without getting any beyond the curb line. Now let's be clear, in a situation like this, you would think that it would be smart just to put the edge of the bucket along the curb line and plow forward, picking the snow up. But when you have zero tolerance for spillage over the curb, you cannot do that. Everything must be back dragged away. So both operators are doing that in this event. Watch how efficient this cage system is in this. The operator running the cage opted to take the actual cage itself off and run it as a straight snow plow, angling the snow away from the curb. And then what he's going to do is he's going to go over and pick up the actual cage to scoop up and carry all of that snow out of the way. Now at this point, the operator running just the plow cage has been able to create the space he needs, and now he's going to go get the containment portion and hook into that. You can see the operator running the bucket in the background is about halfway through the back dragging process. So the other operator is going over, he's going to pick up and hook into that cage, and you're going to see that happen. And then he's going to go back over and grab all of that snow and carry it to the pile. The cage absolutely dominated this back dragging event night and day. Pretty amazing results in my opinion. The speed and efficiency this system used was beyond what I expected. This cage system was slick. Look how fast you can slide right into the containment unit itself. The operator never has to leave the machine. It was absolutely amazing. But one of the things that I really like is coming up right here. Look at this. The entire cage unit itself can angle. So it's not only a containment plow, but it's also a functioning angle plow with wings. Absolutely phenomenal design. This cage snow plow was easily the best of both worlds. A containment plow and an angle plow all wrapped up in one for a piece of equipment. I absolutely found this thing to be beyond what I expected it was capable of doing. So for the next event, we had to actually dig into this frozen slushy ice. We call it the hog event. What we're trying to do is see how efficient that these containment plows can operate against a standard snow plow. Will the hydraulics be able to hold up on the cage system? Will it allow it to angle and still function besides just being a straight pusher blade? Or will the weight of the snow itself stop the cage system from working? So let's see what happens. Sometimes heavy wet snow like we've staged for this next test can affect the performance of hydraulics on snow plows. The cage system was able to handle the biggest loads we could throw at it and still angle its containment unit. You can see that we have enough of a load on in this case that it's actually slowing this S250 Bobcat down, but the containment unit itself is unaffected. I want to give a big shout out to the guys from Cage, the president, Mike, and Chris, the general manager, both came out and they allowed me to do absolutely anything I wanted with their snowplow system. They didn't stop us, they didn't make suggestions. They said, do whatever you want. And I did. And I will tell you straight up that this is one impressive unit. If you are looking for your most efficient system that you can possibly get dollar for dollar, this cage system was able to backdrag away from curbs better than a snow bucket. It was able to do a high speed snow plow and hog event carry versus a standard snow plow. This system was impressive from start to finish. How you detach it from the containment unit to how you hook back up. And all in all, this is one heck of a good system. Now next time I gotta convince them to leave it with me. Click like, subscribe, and share.